Yes. Welcome, everybody, to the first tournament, the third category, and the bracket for the Reds. Now, I've already tried this once. Unfortunately, reassembly ran out of memory, so I kind of had to disable all my mods. So that's why these guys are spazzing the hell out. That's why the aura builders are just a block of flichel, and yeah, so, about that. Anyway. That's also why Gatka's Lots of Stars is not going to be in there, but it's probably not going to make much of a difference, is it? It's Lots of Stars, it's fine. Anyway, guys, look at all these ships. Today we have Gemini Zero, we have Echo Wake, or Paul, depending on what he wants to be called. He's happy with both, apparently, which is very cool. And then we have Bahamut, Kama 5, Conga, Kudawat, Dr. Wazzlebutt, Drones, Frostflight, Jocrates, Jonas, Grim Tapestry. I love that ship, by the way. Also, like Frostfly's ship and, you know, flipping lemon. What is that even? Also, tomatoes. I leave with lemons and tomatoes. It's going to be an interesting war, I must say. Jocrates, Jonas, yeah, I've already said that. Lord Z, with his mutant tomatoes. Lord Z, with whom I had the nice battleship in the Terrors. Anyway, then we have Petra. We have Phaser Dancer by Amazach. Shaky Box, with his box that I presume shakes. We have the Shoal by Wraith. We have Kanam with his origami fleet. We have Owlfeathers with the Imperial Task Force. Angry Stars by Subogram, Philosophy, and obviously Zorzak Mueller. Because I need to be in my own tournaments. Well, Drones by Oli Cook Me. I need to say everything full, shouldn't I? Otherwise, people. Clear Federation Rebellion. KFD. I like the KFD now. What? No, get back there. You piece of piñata! No. Bracket, let's begin. And hopefully, it doesn't run out of memory on me. I have a lot of memory, and yet, somehow... Alright, so it's Zorzak Mueller versus Frostflight. This might be an interesting battle. In fact, I hope it is, for everyone's sake. So me and my big Crucible battle cruisers, which just get wrecked instantly because they're not that good. And Frostflight with his just Omega turreted Doombringers. Look at that. Look how many turrets on that darn thing. Insanity. Now, I mean, if the Crucible decides to shoot properly and like a sane thing, yeah, then it can do that. Also have some Vexor support craft and... No, I'm gonna die. No, okay. Wow. Well, thank you, Principal. Frostflight, I like your ships. Look at all these engines. Very maneuverable. Also love the color scheme, because you are Frostflight. Of course everything's going to be blue. Oh, gosh. My armada is getting annihilated. Can I just say this? It's like the one last ship remaining is just the Crucible. Will it survive? Well, apparently it's dealing with all Frostflight's little ships, which I like. Look at these little things. He's so cute! He's so cute! And all these drones as well. Whoa. Me and Frostflight are basically nearly on the same amount of points. Oh gosh! Okay, Crucible's going down here today, chaps. Oh gosh! I found that hilarious. Well done, Frostflight. Gotta say, we were very close though. It was like one ship to three. Now, if these crucibles execute their assault patterns, and I mean, actually, if you, poor Frostflight, he turned his battleships into the Crucible. No, how is the Crucible being this good now? Okay, anyway, stop talking about my own ships. That's very self-centered. Frostflight's ships. Very nice looking ship, but does it have much PD, Frost? I don't think it actually has any PD. Doesn't seem to have much PD for us, I don't know. Funny how, the ZZ, the Zorzakian Zealots have sort of turned this around this time. Like, what happened? Also, a nice thing with the Reds is the battles are almost... You almost can't tell what's going to happen with the Reds. Almost. Because the Reds are so weak and yet so powerful. That it's like a wild card. And Zorzak won this time. Last time Frost won by quite a bit, and this time Zorzak won by quite a bit. It's like, what is going on? I mean, it all happens, it has to do with how this first engagement is executed, because if Frostflight's main battle cruisers sort of survive, and if I lose a crucible or two, then I'm instantly doomed. And same with Frostfire. If he loses the bulk of his ships in this first incursion, which he did, he's gonna suffer some serious losses later on. Also, I have some small fighters, and Frostfire also has some small fighters, which... Look at these little things, they're quite cute. Look at them, like, they've got like little pieces. Sorry, Frost. I don't want to babyify your armada. In fact, I don't want to babyify my own armada. Oh, Frost, no! No, Frost! You can't lose to me. You can't lose to me. That's not something people can do, okay? It's against the rule book. Oh, anyway. Now we have the Clear Federation Rebellion, the KFD. Goodbye, Grim Tapestry versus Jonas and his Swarm Fleet, it would appear. Now, Grim, did you really just take some normal motherships and put them in? So what the heck is this? Grim, what is... Why is this... Why is this a thing, Grim? Why is this here? Why does it need to exist? What is its point? Why does it have factories on it? Why? It's kind of a waste. I suppose he wanted to paint himself a grim tapestry. Well, actually, knit himself a grim tapestry. Not knit. Stitch. No. You know what I mean. He wanted to crochet his own grim tapestry. He made himself a very grim tapestry of death. Poor Grim. I suppose that was, I don't know, maybe it's supposed to be like the frontal wall for his armada, but, you know, random spawning. So unfortunately, we can't trust it. Unless it was just literally just there to be amusing. Unless it was there to just be a factory stick. In which case, factory stick, woo! Oh gosh. Run, Clear Federation Rebellion. Run, KFD. Run, by Grim Tapestry. Jonas, in his very pink and deathlier battleships. I don't know. Look at that. Just bark. Look at this sword for just pink. Pink is winning over orange and red. I cannot have this. What is this? I'm kidding. Look, I need to commentate, so I need to say something amusing. Therefore, whatever I say may or may not be insane. So I like Grimm's main ships. If only they didn't just die so quickly. I mean, all ships die quickly, but that's beside the point. Why? Sometimes I need to just murder the AI. It's a little bit funny. Because it shouldn't do that sort of thing. I don't know. I don't know, Arthur. I'm sorry, Arthur. But, I mean, you know. I'm sorry, mate. I'm sorry. I'm just, you know. So, we have drones. So, yes. So the Clear Federation, what survives is his drone launchers. Which could, in the end, almost win it for him. Because drones have, you know, obviously damage. They can scoop up some points. Get out of there, KFD. Get out of there, Grim Tapestry. KFD by Grim Tapestry. Sorry. KFD. Does that remind anyone of KFC? Ducky fried chicken. No, just no. None of that. Watch this video just get banned or something. I don't know. Get copyright infringement. Because I said Kentucky. Fried, licking, mickin', schmickin', bickin'. Anyway, now we have Echoake, or Paul, versus Petra. Oh, gosh. Well, alright. Oh, gosh. Petra just lost one of his battleships. It's a Tempest Cruiser. It's just kind of... It's like, no, mate, don't worry, mate. We're just going to wait until the bulk of our armada is dead, then I'll only run in and assist. That's my tacticality, that's my intense tacticality. Petra, I think you need to fire whoever the hell that captain is. Look at him now, he's just like, I am a hero, it's like he just goes riding in, and then he dies. GG. Sorry, Petra, but well done, Echoake. Well done. Echoake with his Swarm Battalion. Swarm Company. Swarm Squad. This can't be a squad. That's so many units. That's like a battalion. Well, company's around about 130 soldiers. Battalions, like... My grandfather He was a company. I think a battalion commander, or platoon. I can't remember. He had about 130 soldiers under his command. So, you know, bit of interesting back history here, just, you know, which is technically why I like combat so much. It's just, it's in me blood, man. It's in me blood. I like tacticality of war, but not obviously not the war aspect. Obviously not the idea of people dying, but it's more the intense tactics that have to go into that go into making an effective battle strategy. Sorry, Petra, but make awake beat you. All right, now we have Kainan, Origami Fleet. Origami, yeah, versus Dr. Wazzle. Which is such a... Just don't Google Wazzle, please. For your own sake, don't Google Wazzle. Just don't. Dang it, Conga. Yeah, me and Conga were having a conversation about the doctor's name. Excuse me. Yeah, okay, anyway. So, Kainan Origami Fleet. I like the look of this fleet. It's very nice. Very blue and... I mean, not blue. What? Very white and red. Very... Yeah, origami. It's either Japanese or Chinese. I'm sorry, I don't know my Asian cultures. I don't know them, nor do I know where things originated from. So please don't throw spears at me, or pitchforks, or, I don't know, jack-o'-lanterns, or some inane level of assaultery. I'm referring to the entirety of human culture here, not the Asian areas. Okay? When I say, please don't... you know, I'm digging myself a ditch somehow. I'm digging myself a ditch by trying to get out of the ditch, by not stating that I'm getting out of the ditch, but I'm still holding a rifle because I was in a combat scenario with someone who doesn't exist. And then the people outside the ditch were just like, what the hell are you doing? Anyway, Kainan wins. Sorry, Doctor. Sorry. So now we have drones by Odi Kukmi versus Kudo Watt. Oh gosh, Kudo Watt seems to like his little swarm battalions. Kudo, come on. Come on, Scudo. This is my tournament. You don't have to send in a storm for this. You can just have insane levels of... No. Okay. Back to the Odi Kudo Pseudo War. Wait, what? Odi Kudo Pseudo War. the Odi Kudo Pseudo War. Oh gosh, Odi Cookie's getting annihilated by Kudo Watt. Well, guess what? Today, Pink gets defeated by Ready Orange. Unfortunately. I mean, it's not unfortunate, but it is. It's unfortunate for Odi, because he just got annihilated, but... it's good for Kudo, because he gets to move on. You know what, Kudo? Swarms. Camo 5 was quite sad, of course, quite... kind of irritated about being defeated by Kudo watching the Terran. He wasn't... very irritated, but from what he wrote, he seemed a little bit irritated. It's like, if I had more time, that swarm would have died to my fleet. It's like, yes, Camo, but I'm pretty sure most people would say that. That's what most people want, is just more time. It's like, I vote we extend it to 3 minutes and ignore point victory. I mean, if someone makes a mod for that, sure, but then if you don't have point victory, then you might as well not even have time. Might as well just have a fight to the death forever. But that also means that these tournaments would carry on for far too long. Anyway, Kudo Watt won. So, this could be expected. I think he did. I kind of zoned out in the end. But now we have Shoal by Wraith versus Lord Z Mutant Tomatoes. I guess you want Mutant. But for some reason, I'm reading it like Mutant. Mutant. It's Mew. Mutant. Mutant Tomatoes. Lord Z with his mutant tomatoes. Tomato or tomato? Tomato, tomato, potato, potato. Who says potato? I suppose Americans. Ah, I'm kidding. Gosh, don't you dare take offense. I don't like it when people take offense. Because then I have to find a gate to get around it. When people take offense, you need to set up... Oh gosh, sorry. When people take offense, you need to set up a gate. Well done. Well done, Lord Z, with his mutant tomatoes. Tomatoes. It makes sense. Toma and then toes. Tomatoes. Tomatoes. What am I fighting for? Like, why? Why am I picking... Why am I just making beef with something that doesn't want to make beef? It's like, no one here is going to argue with me about tomatoes. So why am I arguing? Why? Makes no sense. Makes no sense. I'm going to be insane. Anyway. Poor Wraith is getting decimated. Oh no, Wraith. Wraith. Okay, yeah. I mean, Wraith's weakness is swarm fleets. So, Lord Z, Mutant Tomatoes. AKA Swarm Commando Alpha. I want to verse him against the Lemons, and I hopefully maybe even that will happen. Sorry. Mutant Tomatoes win. Sorry, Wraith. Sorry. Where is the Lemon? No, the Lemons and Tomatoes are the complete opposite sides. So now we have Phaser Danza by Amazigh versus Philosopher. So, who's going to win this? I don't know. I'm not entirely sure, sir. It could be either one's game. However, it would appear that Phaser Dancer has slightly larger ships, more due to a lack of hullery than philosophy. Also, Red Faction thrusters have an interesting cost system. So I don't know who would win this. Also, without Gatka's Lots of Stars, yeah, this is way bit easier to watch, isn't it? Far less distraction. Sorry, Gatka, but it works better this way. So, Philosopher is dying to a Amazigh. For some absurd reason. Because Amazing's just got lots of phases. Phases are good, man. Phases are solid weapon systems. Also, just because there's lots of big thrusters. Now, if I go hunt down, what if I need to check something. So, this is Daedalus 4 and this is Daedalus 10. Mass, thrust. Okay. Yeah, I'm sorry, Amazing, but I need to look at something for my own benefit. And since I can't really stop the tournament here, you know, I kind of have to... Sorry. So I kind of just have to stop it there. So yeah. Whoa! Philosopher! Whoa! He survived by one ship! That was amazing! Also, I just need to go into command mode. There we go. Instantly runs better. Because then it's not drawing all the inter lines and... all the internal lines and all the connecting bits. Okay, so... Philosopher won by some amazing chance of insanity. So, it's one plasma, it's one phaser versus two phaser. Big thrusters versus little thrusters. slightly more spatialized armor versus more compact armor. It would appear that compact armor spells the doom of you. So, you know... use big engines as your armor. Camo 5 and a Amazigh. They use the engine defense tactic, it would appear, sometimes. Philosopher is still just raking in points. Look at that. Just just digging up points, shoveling them in. They are the shovelers. What is this? Philosopher could win this again. I want Philosopher to win this again. He has to just... come on. That was such an amazing win last time. 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. No! No! Face a dance of my amazing win. Oh, that is funny. Oh, that is supremely funny. Supremely funny. this battle line, it's barely moving. Okay, now it's moving in the way of amazing. Amazig. He's not amazing. He's a Amazig. that could almost be taken as a backhanded compliment, but it should not be. Everything I say should not be taken in an offensive manner. That is not at all how I intend for it to be used. I intend for it all to be used in a joking and amusing and equally bystanding construct. Any aggression or aggravation caused by the LSN in such times of haphazard comedicality is to be ignored and taken as a simple but very friendly Asmotarian. If that makes any sense to you, congratulations. Also, 16, 15, 14. Philosophy is going to win because he just is that little guy over there. Unless it flies into death. 10, 9, 8, no, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, come on. Yes. 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 Oh, gosh. Amazing. That was so amazing. That was so sorry, Mazur, you lost there. But philosophy beat him. Best battle ever. Now we have Shaky Box with his just insanity class battalion versus Angry Stars by Supple Crumb. They look like Angry Stars. They look really cool. Oh, yeah. I mean, Faction 3 is a great faction for building things. You can build some very awesome looking things, but I mean, compared to Terran, it's almost more constricted, unless you think out the box. If you want to build as like Faction 3, you have to think so bloody out the box. Oh gosh, Shaky, you should have had way more point defense on that, man. If you had sacrificed just two drone launchers, you could have put on so much PD, and, you know, I mean, okay, yeah, you need all those drone launchers, but I mean, you could have actually probably just sacrificed one generator and put in, like, tons of PD. Just tons of it. I don't even think you need that many generators. I mean, the Crucible, I think, operates on less. I don't know, though. Time. Jakey Box. No, he got defeated by Sample Crumb. So, Crumbs versus versus Boxes. Crumbs win. What? Gosh, okay. You have giant space lemons and mini lemon drops. 35k by Gemini Zero. Versus Jocrates, 35k, Faction 3. Oh gosh, look at these lemons. Wow, that's amazing, man. That's amazing. It's solidly a Mazach. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, amazing. I'm kind of abusing your name. I don't mean to. I just want some amusementology. So giant space lemons wins. You grow giant space lemons from a giant space lemon tree, as far as I'm aware, and as far as I've been led to believe. I believe that the giant space lemons also have made friends with the giant space spaghetti monster. Once again, no offense meant. If I'm somehow putting my foot into something that I shouldn't be, that I'm completely and totally unaware of. Imagine if there was a religion of giant space lemons. Sorry, I'm just being drawn out. Wait, that guy looks like Pac-Man. Just think about it. Like yellow and little cut mouth Pac-Man. Giant space lemons and mini lemons. Lemons, man, they beat things. It's like a troll fleet. Hey, wait! A bloody second. The next time I see that, I'm gonna just... Anyway. So now we have Camo 5 versus Zorzak Mueller. Camo 5 going for the swarm tactics today. Nice looking ships, Camo, but still. Yeah, they are nice looking ships, but they're just swarm tactic-y. Go Vexer! No, Vexer! The Vexer got a crash. Just... me versus Camo 5, how anticlimactic. Anyway, I thought the Crucible would do pretty well against swarm fleets. It has lots of Mesaic defensory, but yeah, Yeah. So Camo is kind of doing the same thing as Amazing. And Kudo What and Philosophy to just have phases on your ships. Phases are good guns, man. They're really good. They're blimmin' powerful. Same as Tempests. You win, Camo. Sorry, Lapaps, now. But you, you're out. Sorry, man. Yes, I'm talking to myself, because I can. Now we have Paul versus Jonas. Now this battle is anyone's guess, because this is Swarm Flea versus Swarm... Actually, no, it's not really. I mean, it's Swarm Fleet versus Morm Fleet, because it's a medium swarm. It's a medium swarm, so it's a Morm. Whereas Echo Echo is a small swarm. Swarm. Because ratio... Not ratio. Seismagorically, Echo Echo is small ships, therefore it's a small swarm. And Jonas has medium ships, so it's a Morm. And if you had large ships, and you have a large ship swarm, then you would have a Lorm. And if you had just gigantic ships, you'd have a Gorm. Look, I'm making it a thing. This is an intense tacticality systemization. Oh no, Jonas, you're down to your one ship against 139. Yeah, I didn't think that was going to work. Oh gosh, okay. Well, pink is losing to red. Well, maroon. It's not maroon. It's like dark red. Dark as the night red, sort of. That's nice. Oh, what I'd give for some chips right now. Oh, I want some chips. Sorry, guys, really off topic. But I just want some chips. I just want a snack right now. I haven't even had breakfast. This is early in the morning. I'm just doing it now, because why the heck not? While I'm awake and still have lots of my mental faculties working for me. Oh gosh, so yeah, Echo Egg is just decimating Jonas. Now, Echo Egg has just gone for blasters. Echo Egg's just gone for a blaster assault force. Whereas Jonas has big guns, and yeah, you know what? It's like David and Goliath, if anyone knows the Bible. It's like David and Goliath. David, little guy, just beats Goliath, massive giant. So it's that sort of tacticality, where here we have billions of Davids versus lots of Goliaths. It's quite funny. So yeah, once again, Kudo What with his burst pulse assault force. This is K-Nam, Origami Fleet, 30k death. No, Origami Fleas! No! No, he's getting crushed, he is! He's getting crushed, he is! Oh no! I'm so sad, mate. Why? Yeah, it's going. Oh, sorry. Yeah, K-Nam got... obliterated. Sorry, K-Nam. K-Nam, where's your war barrier? Where's your war banner, I mean? Barrier? Where's your war banner? Where's your war banner, K-Nam? I saw it, but it's not here. It's so sad, K-Nam. Where's the war barrier? Banner. It's quite unfortunate. Yeah, I'm holding out high hopes for Kudo What. And as I'm sure I mentioned in the farmer bracket, you know, if you think about it, you waste quite a lot of pee having a swarm than you would having a normal armada. Okay, anyway, here we have Lord Zeb, Mutant Tomatoes versus Conga with his drone swarm, apparently. Trying to remember what it was called because the name's not here. It's drone swarm, as far as I'm aware. That battle line, just battle line. I love battle lines. They're so cool. it just looks very epic. Just to have a battle line. I always love to imagine I'm just a little ship flying around in the, like the middle of this massive battle, and just I'm not getting shot at, but I'm watching all these battles and there's epicness and there's just explosions and it's all vibrantly colored, it's all like neon red and just epic stuff. And for me, that would be like heaven. Just if I get to fly in that battle and that battle goes on forever and it's just always new and adaptive ships just coming in, fighting. And for a little bit of time, one side will win, then the other side will win, then one side will deploy like a Titan or something. And just these epic scenic scenarios. Like, if any of you have watched my scenic scenarios, Battleship Forever, you know, that's kind of what I enjoy doing. I love forever battles. I love eternal combat. That's just epic. Endless war. I love it. It's just a beautiful thing to watch. Especially if that endless war is constantly evolving. I wouldn't say evolving. Adapting would be a better term. Evolve is kind of a loose term. I would guess. I prefer adapt. Because you're adapting to the circumstances, which is evolve. But you know what I mean? Okay. So, two Blimmin' Swarm Fleets against each other. I didn't even take note of who won last time. But, I mean, Conker's a very dronular Swarm Fleet. He does have some, like, he has some Burst Pulse and some... Not Burst Pulse, what am I talking about? He has some Pulsers and some just anti-swarm ships. Some anti-drone ships, actually. Which is a good idea. I mean, you do you ever really see if, okay, you see it right here, actually. Here, so Mutant Tomatoes actually has dedicated that he swarmed for ships as well. But look at this battle line. Ah, it's so beautiful. Just, And what I also like is just sort of the background of these massive battles. Just watching, like, say... Because if you're going to have, like, an eternal battle, you're going to have, like, space stations at either side. You're going to have your bases. And those bases are going to be churning out armies, you know? The bases are going to be building units. And then you'll have your resource fields, which will be gathering units, gathering resources. And you have your little ships that go and gather the resource from the resource field, bring it back to the base. The base takes the resource, builds more ships, sends it all to the front line. You have these epic battles, these massive motherships just unloading death upon each other, just... Then you have these odd, like, little incursions into enemy space, and these little forces go after the resource mining operations, and just, it looks awesome. At least in my mind. I don't think I've ever really seen a game that can do that brilliantly. Yeah, wow, well done, Conga. Well done. you turned it back. Conga turned it back on the mutant tomatoes. Drones, man, drones. Drones are really cool. Drones are a really cool idea because, okay, first of all, just look at this. That just looks awesome. Oh, look at that. This is why I love war and that sort of tacticality of it. Just the beauty. Not the loss of life, that's the sad part, but the tactics and the tacticality. How do you push forward a battle front with only limited amounts of forces? The enemy also have limited amount of forces, and that's the thing you have to keep in mind. How do you increase the enemy's how do you decrease their morale? Morale is an important thing, because if your soldiers don't have morale, they aren't going to fight very effectively. So Conga has a mixture of, well, quite a few ships, drones and assault ships, and you know, it's a balanced armada, and in the end that's what you would just usually win. Are these Conga's ships? I can't tell because both the color schemes are so similar. Come on, guys. I really can't tell who's on whose team. Okay, I mean, I can tell it's a mutant tomato. And I can tell it's a Congerian. Yeah, I know. I'm going to call it a Congerian. Because Conga's ships have lasers on them. There we go. Fire. I mean, not lasers, but drones. So Conga's going to win this on points. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Conga wins. Wow, it's a few of Conga's ships remaining. Gosh. So now we have Philosopher, who beat a Mazach. Now we have Angry Stars by Supplecrumb versus Philosopher. They are the philosophizers. Look, if you don't give yourself like a dedicated fleet name, I'm going to make up one for you, because I want to have that level of cool role-player-y. So the philosophizers are going ham on a biscuit on these Angry Stars. I wonder what upset these stars. I don't know. What would make the star get upset? How would a star design a complex thrusting system, a mechanism, and generator? And how would a star engineer a battleship? These are all the questions you've got to ask yourself. On a daily basis. Oh, gosh. Ouch, Sample. Getting shot at by philosophy. It's annihilated. Sample, I need to just check out your generators. Yeah, so Sample's generators are quite close to the top. I mean, he can't really avoid that, can he? But it doesn't, yeah. Very nice ship, though, Sample. Very nice ship. Philosophy, you also have nice little ships. I don't know how many different types of ships you have, Philosophy, but we appear to all sort of just... Yeah, it's all sort of just the same ship. No, it is all just the same ship. Alright, the final four. So now we have Camo 5 versus the Trolley Lemons. Which move, okay, they move, and actually at a decent pace. So guess what, they don't count as troll ships. Well done, Gemini Zero, well done, you followed the rule book. Speaking of people who followed the rule book. There was a guy who made Elbert. He made a Delayle Spinner Fleet in Terrans. You'll remember this, because I said it was going to be banned, and well, not really banned, but sort of disqualified. He sent me an email, and two videos, just explaining, like your default spinner, and then his spinner. His spinner is a delayed spinner, because I looked at it, and he explains sort of the physics behind it, and I have to say, I love ships that sort of use physics. Use physics to advantage. I don't, because spinners are a little bit OP, but he explained how his ship worked. It's really cool, because for the first time, for first amount, for like 4 seconds, about, he says 4 seconds. I think it's more like, maybe even, it's either three or five, depending on how quick the AI takes the target. But his ships actually just fly normally. His ships just kind of fly straight-ish. A little bit off target, just due to center of mass. But then once he fires his torpedoes, that's when the actual spinning starts. Because then it debunks the mass and destabilizes the mass, and then his thrusters kick in to write the orientation. But then that thrust is so powerful that it actually just spins the ship. And then those thrusters keep on firing, trying to write the orientation again, I presume. And then, yeah. So, okay, first of all, Camo 5 is just causing these poor giant space lemons to have a hell of a time. No, Gemini Zero! Gemini Zero! Can I just say I love the name Gemini? Gemini, I like it. If I were to have a son, just Gemini. Gemini! We're going to go wreck some universes, son. We're going to go wreck some universes. A very nice ship, I must say. Look at all those thrusters as well. Look at that, it can turn, it can fly. It counts as a battleship for me, man. It counts as a battleship. A little bit off-center! This sidular area sort of hurts my mind for some reason. Yeah, Camo 5 wins. Because of armor and... What does he have? Just his armors and phases on, like, everything. Armors, phases, and thrusters. Yeah, you'll notice a Camo 5 and a Mazach are both using the bigger thrusters. That's because... Well, obviously bigger thrusters are more effective, correct? Yeah, correct. Also... Well... They have a lot more health. I love these giant space lemons. Can I just say they're pretty darn awesome? These little lemon drops. These are quite cute. You could easily put a little bit of armor in there, and it would barely make a difference. Get wrecked, Camo. Look, at least Camo was defeated in the Terran tournament. I think people are happy about that. So he can win some other things. It's fine. It's fine. 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 Try hard commando today. Yes. Try hard commando, but his ships do look quite nice. But in the battle of looks here, Giant Space Lemons wins. Just giant space lemons all the way. Zerglings. Allergic to lemons. Yeah, I know, I just like out of nowhere just went Zerglings. I waited a bit. Allergic to lemons. I don't know. Anyway, Giant Space Lemon sort of sets up like a wall, and he just stops Gamma 5. It's hilarious. You know what, Gemini? If all you guys had just like a drone launcher on them each. These giant lemons are perfect as a wall, okay? They go, they die, they act as a giant formidable wall, and they stop the army. Then you send in your drones, and your drones just rake in the points. Just, so many points. Oh, beautiful. And, because, I mean, the bulk of your army is just chilling. For some reason. Sorry, for some reason I'm tired. I think it's just the darkness of my room. I need to open up my blinds. Open the blinds. Let in the great South African sun. Oh, da, da, da. Oh, hello, Widget. Hello, my little doggy. Oh, that'll wake me up. Oh, that's nice. So while I wait for about 15 seconds, I'm just going to stare out at the sun. Oh. Ah, nice day. Like it to rain. Widget. Gooey. Careful. What you doing? Sorry. She's standing by the pool, and I worry about her. She's a little dog, and she can't swim too well. She's very... I suppose you can call her fat. But she's not fat. She's a little wily-haired terrier. Just... I mean, that's what people think she is. We actually have no idea. She's like a pavement special. Anyway. Kudo what? Versus Akoake. This could be, like, this is like a Titan on Titan battle, because these two both have good swarm fleets. Difference is, Kudowatt is using phases, or pulses, whichever the name is. You know, I am in the tournament, I can just go check. Phaser! I was right, okay, nice. And Akoake is just using blasters. Much better. Where's my dog? Where's she gone? Yeah, I literally have a window overlooking the pool and the rest of my garden, so... Hello, Wedgie. Hello! I can just sort of, like, talk to her from here. Oh, my little dog. Anyway, I have a couple other dogs, you know, just sort of side-dartorial input. So Kudo, what is annihilating Akoake? Poor Akoake. No, Paul! Paul! No, man, you're dying! That's quite unfortunate. Paul's a nice chap. He seems like a nice chap, I must say. But yeah, he's getting annihilated here by phasers. Phasers are powerful, man. They're good guns. I mean, you can tell how much damage they do just by the size of the barrel. Not that much range, as you can tell from the length of the barrel, but as you can tell from the size of the barrel, it's quite damaging. As you can tell from the size of the blaster, the blaster doesn't do so much damage either. Yeah, I love the way that Arthur sort of represents the damage and power of a gun, and sort of how it works. in sort of the physicality aspect of it, because it's a powerful gun, it's big, and you can tell if it's a powerful gun by just looking at it. You know, you get what you see. And if it's a long range gun, it's a long barrel. if it's rapid fire, it has multiple barrels. You know, it's really cool stuff what Arthur did. Genius. He's a genius, man. He's a good programmer. okay, anyway. Coup de what, you know, as we saw, kind of unfortunately decimating Paul, because Paul just... Paul isn't using... pulse gun phases. He's just using blasters. Sorry, Paul. Wow, look at Owl Feathers. He rode it all the way to, like, the third. Don't Owl. Anyway, now we have Bahamut versus Konga. Oh, gosh. Darn it. Okay. Well, Bahamut's gonna get wrecked. Boom. No. I love... Can we just take a moment to just kind of admire just that beautiful, like, little coil construct in the middle of Bahamut's ship? It looks beautiful. It's like it looks like a shield almost. It looks like that's a shield bubble, but it's not. I like it. Well done, Bahamut. Oi! Who's barking out there? Oh, he's barking. Alright, so the neighbor's dog's not mine. Alright. As long as it's not mine, I'm happy. So yes, Bahamut is kind of getting wrecked because Swarm Armada. No, Bahamut. Bahamut has a lot of lasers on this thing, gosh. A lot of designated just laser guns. Still gonna just chewed away by Konga. Yeah, those phases, man, they're cheap and effective. Actually, that gives me an idea for a Terran swarm fleet. By the way, I've been talking in this, like, low melodrome sort of voice of mine, and it's literally vibrating my teeth. Ah! Oh, my teeth feel so weird. So weird indeed. Oh, God. Sharkan, yorkan, sierkan, merkan. That literally means nothing, by the way. There were no swear words or foul language used. Oh. My teeth are vibrating. I need to talk in a voice that is not my normal... repercussive voice, otherwise my teeth, they feel so weird. Oh, sorry, Bahamut, but Konga wins. Beautiful ships, though, Bahamut, beautiful. So now we have Philosophy versus Owl Feathers. Owl Feathers, of whom just kind of, oh, I love those ships, ah! But they're very, very dark and black. Black is the void. Oh, gosh, those things look dangerous. Oh, look, those ships, right? Yeah, very nice. Look at that ship. Well, an owl. That looks very nice. So you have Owl Feathers 0117, Imperial Task Force. Number 578134. By the way, that's a lot of Imperial Task Forces, if you think about it. If this is just that number, either, like, as they die, you just don't want to, like, replace the number, and, like, you know, just sort of like them, sort of keep them in, like, a... Luigi, what are you barking at? Okay, that's a little more of an aggressive bark, and I'm slightly too concerned about that. But anyway, Owl Feathers, his Imperial Task Force, has unfortunately been routed. I like owls. I like owls. He's like me. He sends in just... beautiful armadas. They're beautiful and powerful, but gosh, I mean, like, his okay, gosh, my dogs are going ballistic. I'm on a biscuit. I need to give me a moment. Hello, everybody, I'm back, and so it's nothing, it's fine. Gosh, I say that in a way as if there is something going on. So I also got myself a rusk because I'm actually hungry. So yeah, now Alphys, I think, has gone for quite a what I would call it a balanced offensive. My dogs are barking again. Oh gosh. Give me a moment. How to do? I'm back again. So in philosophy, I wins. Oh, now we're down to the last two. So now it's Kudowatt versus Camo 5. Can Kudowatt defeat Camo 5 again? I honestly hope he could, because that would be highly amusing. That means that Camo 5 could gripe again. I don't want Camo to gripe again. Honestly, I want everyone to kind of be happy, but it's impossible in a bracket tournament. A pool tournament, then everyone's kind of fine, because then you know you've kind of had an even battle, an even spread. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I'm eating a rusk because I just haven't had breakfast yet. So, after this tournament, breakfast ho. Breakfast ho! I just run off and dramatically wield a sword or some sort of spatulotic implement. Just make myself some egg and bacon. Anyway. I mean, were requested to be made of me, I could do one of two things. Wait, what? Made of? That sounds weird. No, I mean, I could request it to be made for me by someone else. That's what I mean. Anyway. Annihilated. Oh no, come on Kudo, you have to, good, nice, okay, now, calm and concise, targeting computers, activate targeting, yes, nice, well done Kudo, sorry Camo, sorry. Come on Camo, how can you be defeated by Kudo, how Camo, how can you allow this to happen Camo, this isn't a thing. What is this? This will be the second time in a row that Kudo won his defeating Camo. Unless it was somehow a fluke of luck. Cameron's gonna lose this. Go ahead, Kudo won in points. Gosh. I'm sorry if you hear me chewing. I'm so sorry. It's just I'm really hungry. Woohoo! Kudo won wins. Yeah. That's between Camo 5, sorry, that's between Conga and Philosophia. And honestly, I have no idea who could win this. Oh, Camo. I mean, Conga's lost the bulk of his ships. Oh, gosh. Out of four ships. And yes, I'm literally just licking up the last crumbs of my rusk. Nice. Delicious. Ah, delicious and not too nutritious, but something to nom on. Anyway, well done, Philosopher. Gosh. So we have 350 ships versus 513. Philosopher is victorious. Wait. So Philosopher beats Amazigh. Kuduat beats Camo. We need to have perfect. I see the comedy. The beater of the victor of Amazigh and the victor of Camo will verse off against each other. Oh, man, that is utter and complete comedy. That is really quite funny, actually. This is like a beautiful scenario, actually. Wow, impressive. Not this, but I mean the overall thing. I mean this is too. Poor Conga. With the Terran tournament, he took quite great offense when after our battle, I went like, now this is a battle armada, because it was like two things. He was just like, what's wrong with slow ships? Like, nothing, man, nothing. I say things independently of each battle. So, and if I say one thing at one battle and then another thing in another battle, just know that I'm not really comparing anyone. I really don't mean to. So now we have Philosopher versus Coda. What? Flippin' swarm fleets. Look at this. Just look at this. I'm gonna put a darn ship thingy. I mean, this looks awesome. Like, seriously awesome. But I mean, I might just put a max of like 200 ships. Because although my computer can handle it, I don't know. I think we just need to have a sort of sanity limit on swarm fleets. Just maybe 200. I think 200 is nice. Just so you know, we can have some bigger ships to just have some crazier, I don't know. I mean, the more ships we have, the crazier it is, but then the more ships you have, the less individual firepower, and the more just... Then it's more like fighting Creeper. If you've ever played Creeper World, it's like you're fighting a sludge. Once there are enough things there, you're just fighting a flood of just gunk, really. It's you're not fighting at one individual entity, and that makes it harder. But it also makes it easier, depending on your choice of weapon system. So if you ever played Creeper World, it's basically you versus a kind of a sentient liquid, which is really quite hilariously epic. Great game. Alright. I brought one more Rusk with me, so... Anyway, Kuduat wins! Yay! Woohoo! Kuduat wins! Where's Kuduat? Yeah! Kuduat! Do. I mean, this is the legitimacy bracket, but still. That was so epic. So Kuduat beat Amazigh, beat Camo 5. Got it. So Kuduat beat Camo 5. Philosopher beat Amazigh. And then these two fought off against each other. That was amazing! That was pretty darn awesome! That was stupendous. Well done, guys. Well done. Good game. All right. GG, everybody. So until next time, you know what I'm going to say. Cheerio.